very delicious. I am Louisiana Strawberry Queen, and on behalf of Tangy Tourism, I'm inviting you to enjoy the biggest and sweetest Louisiana strawberries at this year's Strawberry Festival in Ponchatoula.
We're at the crossroads of Louisiana, where good food, good times, and good people meet.
Well, you know, Brigette Hyde is a member of the Parish Council, but sometimes she's just the District 9 representative, and such is the case on the eve of the Strawberry Festival. This is it, and I'll concede to you a little civic pride. Number one.
Yes, wear my strawberry bracelet tonight. I love the Strawberry Festival. I was actually a board member for 10 years. It's just a great organization, and their goal is to put back money into the community, into our farmers' pockets, and into our nonprofit organizations.
And so, we're counting down the days now.
Yes, we're excited. I've been seeing a lot of posts on Facebook. People are excited because it's festival week, and it's a big deal to Ponchatoula and to our residents.
When you talk about Tangibahoe's festival season, I think to the rest of the state, they hear it and they know it's true that we have the largest number. But the Strawberry Festival is in a class by itself, second only to Mardi Gras in the whole state.
That's true, Ken. It's the largest festival in the state. I think we bring in about 300,000 visitors through our little city through that weekend, which is just unbelievable for the size of our town. But, you know, our people are very welcoming and people like to come here. There's so much for them to do with the crafts. They can buy strawberries. We have the rides on the park. The food is phenomenal. It's just a great weekend.
And you know, there are a lot of nonprofits that literally get 100% of their annual budget by the money they make at the Strawberry Festival.
Exactly. A lot of them. You see a lot of the fraternities and sororities, our civic clubs, a lot of the school clubs. This is their main source of income for the entire year. So the weekend is a big deal to them.
There's no telling in economic development how much we have gotten in terms of businesses moving here, residents moving here, because they came to the Strawberry Fest and just fell in love with the place.
Yeah, I think that's Frank Vallow's story. He came here for the Strawberry Festival and he's built a big business here. So people come here and they love it and they want to come back every year.
Well, I don't know whether it's the pandemic or what, but every time you have an annual event now, it's the biggest one they ever had. And I'm certainly convinced with the weather forecast like it is, that'll be the case with the Strawberry Festival, biggest ever.
Yeah, last year was record-breaking. And so I think that we're just going to continue to build on that. And, you know, people weren't able to do anything for so long, and now they're just excited to get out and get to do things. And like you said, the weather will be gorgeous in the 70s, during the day. And we've got a lot of really good entertainment lined up there. We have two stages, and the bands start around 12 on Saturday and Sunday, and they play, all through the evening. So there's a little bit of something for everybody. There's a lot of versatility in the types of music. So the food, there's pretty much anything that you can think of is served out there, fried oysters, fried shrimp. They do boiled crawfish. There's just pretty much anything that you would want to eat.
So what's your favorite thing at the Strawberry Festival?
So every year after I ride in the parade, I go to the festival grounds and I get a seafood stuffed potato from A Touch of Class. And if I don't get that potato, I haven't gone to the Strawberry Festival. I've missed it on Saturdays and actually driven up there on Sundays just to get my potato. So that is my favorite thing to eat there every year. And then I try to eat an oyster po' boy from Charlie Landry's family's for his scholarship. They're amazing, but just all of the food is so good.
So tell us something about the Strawberry Festival or some attraction there that people wouldn't know about.
Well, the festival grounds. Crazy as that sounds, people come to Ponchatoula every year and they don't even know that there is a festival grounds. That's where all of our official booths, our nonprofits are. That's where the rides are. That's where our bands are. But a lot of people come to town, they walk up and down the street and they see the craft booths, they go in the antique stores and they don't even realize that there is a festival. So, I encourage people to get off the beaten path, go that extra block and find our actual festival grounds.
Well, the festival board, I think, has come up with a neat idea, which is since the festival keeps growing, and since, like it or not, some people don't make it to the festival grounds, they're going to start moving toward having some of their attractions away from the park.
Well, I haven't really heard that. I know they do incorporate 6th Street into their official, part of the park, and there are a lot of rides and booths on, not rides, but booths on 6th Street. But
That might just be an expansion.
Yeah.
It would make sense.
It spreads all over town. You know, there's people set up selling strawberries and crafts and different things. So it's just a huge draw. And then the parade is huge. I would say that it is the biggest parade anywhere in Tangipahoa Parish. And it usually lasts for close to 2 hours. We have over 100 entries, and it's a really, really fun parade. That starts at 9:30 Saturday morning, so I encourage people to come out for that.
What else do you want to share with us?
Just come and enjoy the weekend. Get out, listen to bands, have a good time. Come and see your friends and family. Friday nights, there's music and there's food booths open. So you typically in the past that was just for families, but it's open to the public now, and it's a big night. So come enjoy the whole weekend.
I'm Louisiana Strawberry Queen Lauren Van Mullen, inviting you to enjoy the biggest, sweetest, and juiciest strawberries this year at Ponchatoula Strawberry Festival.
And I'm King Don Lanier, inviting you to experience Louisiana's most popular festival with great food, music, family fun,
and of course strawberries.